Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to study another interesting chapter prescribed in your syllabus, The Hundred Dresses by Eleanor Estes. Today we are going to read the first part of this chapter. It has two parts. But before we proceed further, let's talk about the author. Eleanor Estes was born in West Haven in the United States in May 9, 1906, and died in July 15, 1988. Eleanor Ruth Rosenfield was an American children's author. She was born in West Haven as Eleanor Ruth Rosenfield. Originally a librarian, Estes' writing career began following a case of tuberculosis. Bedridden while recovering, Estes began writing down some of her childhood memories, which later turned into full-length children's books. Estes' book Ginger Pie in the year 1951 won the Newbery Medal, and three of her other books, The Middle Moffat, Rufus M. and The Hundred Dresses, were chosen as Newbery Honor Books. She also received the Certificate of Award for Outstanding Contribution to Children's Literature and was nominated for the Laura Ingalls Wilder Award. By the time of her death, Estes had written 19 children books. Now, let's talk about the background of this chapter. Polish immigrants came from Poland to America. It was a very poor community and was discriminated for this style in United States. And today, the chapter that we are going to read is the story written in the year 1994 and is a sensitive account of how a poor girl is judged by her classmates. The name of the girl is Wanda. She's a young Polish girl who goes to school with other Americans in an American town. These children see Wanda different in many ways, such as she was poor, she was from another country, she has a funny name, she doesn't have mother, she always wears the same faded dress. But when asked, "How many dresses do you have, Wanda?" she will always answer, 100, all lined up. So, the chapter, The Hundred Dresses, is a story of a girl named Wanda who lived up on a hill called Boggins Heights. The story is about people teasing Wanda by asking her how many dresses she had, and she would always say, "I have 100 dresses," when she only had one faded blue dress. One day, her dad pulls her out of class and decides that they are moving to the big city where no one would tease her or make fun of her. To help you better understand the value of respect and acceptance of all the people, let us read the lesson, The Hundred Dresses, Part 1. The story revolves around a girl named Wanda Petronsky and her classmates Peggy and Madeline, who made fun of her. The plot of the story opens up on Monday. Even Peggy and Madeline did not notice that Wanda was not present. These were the girls who begin all the teasing. Wanda generally used to sit in the corner of the classroom where the not so academically brilliant and loud children sat. It was that part of the classroom which was the dirtiest, but Wanda was not like those boys. She was silent to the extent that nobody had ever seen her laugh. Since Wanda was nothing like those boys, no one ever understood why she sat there. There were only guesses that it is because she came from Boggins Heights. And her shoes were hugely dirty with all the mud. People hardly noticed her in the classroom as she was silent and alone all the time. It was only before or after school hours when groups of kids used to wait for her to mock her that they thought of her. Some used to wait even at the cost of getting late for school. The fact that Venda was not present on Tuesday as well got unnoticed. But it was on Wednesday when Medi and Peggy noticed her absence. It was also then when they waited before school to make fun of her, but instead ended up getting late because she didn't show up. Peggy was the most famous girl who wore good and tidy clothes. She sat with the toppers of the class. No one ever got curious about why Venda was no longer coming to school. All they cared was they couldn't make fun of her. Venda was a Pole who had immigrated to America. Her fellow classmates thought that Venda Petronsky was a strange name because they had simpler and easier American names except a guy named Willie Bounce, which they thought sounded funny but still lesser than Petronsky. They found her name to be long and unfamiliar. This shows that those children didn't understand diversity and whatever they did was done out of thoughtlessness. Venda was usually seen wearing a faded blue dress that did not fit her properly. Though clean, it used to look unironed. This shows that Venda belonged to a poor family who could not afford too many dresses. Ironically, a lot of people talked to her, but she didn't have any friends because all of them talked to her in order to make fun of her. From her tale about 100 dresses to her unfamiliar name, they found it all amusing. When she used to watch little girls play in the ground, it was at that time other students surrounded her to mock her. With no intentions of hurting her, Peggy used to ask the number of dresses Venda has in a very polite and respectful tone. They made fun of her because they couldn't understand why she made up that story about 100 dresses. They did all this while being ignorant of the fact that it could hurt her. No one would believe her when she said she possessed 100 dresses all lined up in her closet. As the other girls screamed in astonishment, the little girls would stop playing in order to see what was going on. Venda would affirm their queries that she had dresses made of velvet and silk too. Sadly, after she left, they all used to laugh at her. It was hard to believe what Venda said because the only dress she was seen wearing was the blue one that was faded. No one was sure as to why she lied. Although they were teasing her, they were never rude to her. Thus, in the same tone, they continued asking her about the number of shoes. She said she had 60, each pair different. It was Peggy's idea to embarrass her like that, though she was polite. Peggy and Medi, the inseparable friends, were the last ones to leave school, while Venda would go back all alone with her dull eyes and behaved in a strange way. Peggy was not the mean girl. She had been portrayed as until now. She saved kids from whoever was hurting them and couldn't stand animals getting badly treated. According to her, she was not being rude to Venda. She thought it was very weird of Venda to lie about the number of dresses she possessed, and if anything was weirder, it was her name. Medi did not like the idea of making fun of the number of clothes and accessories Venda possessed, not because she cared about her, but because she was poor herself. She wore clothes that were given to her by someone else, but she was not as poor as Venda. She did not live in Boggins Heights and did not even have a weird name. Mary didn't feel very comfortable teasing Wanda, and when Peggy used to ask Wanda those questions, she would silently count the marbles in her hand, pretending to play with them. If that dress game hadn't been invented, Mary would have never known about the very existence of Wanda. She felt uncomfortable not because she cared about Wanda, but because she was worried she could be next. Although she was not senseless enough to say she had 100 dresses, she still wished that Peggy did not tease Wanda. So Wanda didn't come that day, and after having waited for her so long, Mary and Peggy got late for school. Mary was secretly happy that they could not get a chance to make fun of Wanda. She was lost in her own thoughts and couldn't study properly. All this time, she kept thinking about writing a note to Peggy, telling her to stop making fun of Wanda, which she did write after finishing Arithmetic. She wanted to write a note because she knew she did not have the guts to say it on her face. While writing the note to Peggy, Mary shook at the imagination of her being a new target for Peggy and the girls. She was afraid that they would ask where she got the dress from, which was actually Peggy's. Mary's mother got it transformed with new laces and ribbons so that none of her classmates could identify it. She wished Peggy stopped having fun with Wanda on her own. Suddenly, she ran her hand through her hair as a gesture to drive away all those thoughts. She said to herself, Peggy is the most liked girl in the room, her best friend, and so she couldn't be wrong. Thus, she tore and threw that note away. She was also afraid of losing her friend, Peggy. After Mary had cleared her thoughts about confessing to Peggy, she started thinking about Wanda. She thought that Wanda was just another girl living in Boggins Heights who hardly spoke to anybody. She remembers when Wanda talked about her pale blue dress and jungle green dress paired with a red sash. The girls made fun of her by saying that she would rather look like a Christmas tree in that dress. The next day, when the results were to be announced, it was raining lightly. And thus, the two best friends ran quickly to school without waiting for Wanda. Generally, they used to wait for her at the Oliver Street that led to Boggins Heights, the place where Wanda lived, but they didn't wait that day. Even if it wasn't raining that day, they wouldn't have waited for her because the day was crucial as the results were to be announced. When the best friends entered the classroom, Peggy asked Mary if Miss Mason would announce the results or not, to which Mary said yes. Mary told her that she believed Peggy would win, but to their utmost surprise, when they entered the class, there were drawings all over the room, bright and brilliant. They left everyone in awe. Miss Mason talked about girl submissions. She mentioned that there was one such girl who had submitted 100 designs, each so beautiful that the judges felt that any out of them was worthy of the gold medal. Miss Mason very proudly announced Wanda as the winner of the competition. She continued and sadly mentioned that Wanda has not been coming since days, hoping she would be there the next day. She instructed everyone to look at the flawless collection, to which everyone applauded and whistled. Mary and Peggy even saw the blue dress that Wanda had talked about. It was beautiful. Peggy sighed, I thought I could draw, which means that the drawings left her in immense admiration for Wanda. Now, let's talk about the summary of this chapter, The 100 Dresses. Let's summarize the story. Humiliation of Vanda. Vanda was made fun for her peculiar family name, Petronsky, and poor dress-up. All the school children, especially Maddie and Peggy, used to ask about her name, number of dresses she had, pair of shoes she had, etc. Vanda would say that she had 100 dresses and 100 pair of shoes all lined up in the cupboard. She left school and did not report for many days. She studied in room number 13 of the school. She sat at the last bench of the class and she did not have any friend. Guilt conscience of Maddie. She also belonged to a poor family like Vanda. She was afraid that if others will know about the poverty, that then she will also be humiliated like Vanda. She was unable to stop Peggy to make fun of Vanda because she did not have courage to lose the friendship of her most famous and pretty friend Peggy. Painting competition won by Vanda. In the opinion of students of room number 13, Peggy would win the drawing competition because she was considered as the most talented girl. On the contrary, the competition was won by Vanda in girls' group. In boys' group, Jack won the competition. Vanda had 100 pictures of colorful dresses, but Vanda was not present to receive the award. Now, let's look at the theme of this chapter. The 100 Dresses is a beautiful story based on the theme of discrimination, judgmental attitude people have for others. In this story, we see Vanda being judged for her unique name and qualities. So this chapter or this story teaches us that we should never make fun of the unique differences of our fellow human beings. We should try to accept them as they are and be cooperative with them. That's very important. So we read that 1,000 dresses teaches us something very important. We should never bully anyone in life. We should always be generous towards others. We should always make others comfortable, right? So that was all for today. I hope you all understood the story. Read the text and thanks for listening.